Anybody who has or has had access to a valve radio will probably be able to attest to the sound quality that you tend to get from these things. They were built at a time when hi-fi was not in vogue, but as opposed to hi-fi, which is more a measurable technical term, people used to go for the sound quality that the ears perceived. And so the circuits in these radios, the audio circuits in these old radios, tended to pay special attention to the perceived quality of the sound. Some of the German sets especially went to extreme lengths to get the sound quality just right, with the right tone controls, with very complicated feedback systems to get you the right tone and to fill a room with bass. And that's generally what we find when we listen to these radios. But by themselves, you've got FM, which is very useful today. For how long, we don't know. We've got medium wave, short wave, long wave, and those bands tend to become less and less popular over the years, not only by on the side of the listeners, but also on the actual transmission side. So one of the things that I like to do when I restore these radios, and this is the small, I say small, it is a small one, a Schaub Lorenz Goldie 58. The others are all a lot bigger and sound a lot beefier. So one of the things I like to do is to make this thing useful as a player, as a amplifier for MP3. In my case, it's an iPhone. Just connect it in there, play your music, and you have your wireless, not wireless in this case, but you have your speaker. And the way to do that, as most of you will know, is to use the pickup input. In this particular case, you press those two together and you have the pickup selected. In some radios, most of the other radios, you actually have a separate pickup button. So what you do here, what you're doing here, if you want to use this just as an amplifier for your iPod, your iPhone, your MP3 player, is you're using the pickup input at the back through the power amplifier of this radio, and your music comes out of these speakers. Now, it will still give you control over the sound because your amplifier is controlled by, you've got the volume control here, your bass, and your treble. So what you need to do then is just connect your iPod or your iPhone or your MP3 player at the back, right? Well, it's not as simple as that. Here's the pickup input at the back, and what they used to do is you'd have a record player, a gramophone, that would be separate to this unit. It comes out, you'd plug it in here, select gramophone or pickup at the front, and you'd hear your records being played through your radio. Now, generally, we're quite accustomed to seeing these things. Plug this into the headphone socket of your phone or your MP3 player or your iPod, and your music comes out. How do you get this into that? Well, you push it in. No, that's not it. I'm repeating some pretty simple stuff here, but I was very surprised by how flaky this information is on the net today. You'll see in a minute why. This is your stereo jack. Into here, you have these old jacks, which today happen to be compatible with these 4 mm banana jacks. So if you plug that in there, that goes in, and that one goes in, okay? As you can see pretty clearly, this one isn't noted here, but in some cases you do have it noted that the bottom one is ground and the top one is your pickup signal. So the first thing we notice is that there's only two of them. There's ground and there's your signal because it's mono. This thing has three connectors: ground, left channel, right channel, stereo. So how do I get my stereo signal into the mono? And this is where the crunch of this video comes from. It is amazing how misleading information on the web can be. In so many cases, the advice they've given on how to do this, how to convert stereo to mono, is actually very dangerous to your equipment. Not so much that it'll blow up, but that it will damage it. And it just won't work well enough sometimes. So what I decided to do is to make this simple video just to show you how to make a very straightforward stereo to mono converter without putting your expensive equipment at risk. So basically what we have is we have our right signal, our left signal, our ground. This is coming out of this jack, okay? On the other side of this, you have exactly the same thing. What you want on the other side of this are two of these, okay? What do I do to get the stereo signal coming in as a mono signal through this one here and ground through this one here? That's what I need to do. Now, what some places say you do is you simply stick them together. Simple, right? There's your ground and there's your mono. You know, your left signal is going up and down with music, the right signal is going up and down with music, and what you get here is a mono signal coming out. That could work some of the time, but there's a problem. The rest of the time, it won't. It could actually damage your equipment back here, and the reason is very simple. If we take this signal a bit further back, and let's say this is the MP3 player, what you probably have over here is an op amp driving each of those. Now, your op amp has low output impedance. This is your output of the op amp. Left signal, right signal, left channel, left signal. And if you just simply short them together, what you're going to get is this one trying to push that one. They'll be fighting each other. They literally will consider the other a load because of the low impedance path. In fact, 0 ohms, almost 0 ohms, going from one to the other. And you shouldn't connect op amps like this, even when they are driving the same signal. If these two were driving exactly the same signal and you wanted to connect them together to get more power, you should at least put in a little resistor over here. Now this could be as low as, you know, 20, 30, 40, 50, 100 ohms, okay? That's what you should do. You should never just short them together, because what you'll be doing is overheating one of those or both, okay? Not to mention the distortion that'll occur on your signal. I'm just talking about the stress that these two op amps will go through. So let's forget about that part for now. And we've got our signal coming in, left and right. What do we do to make this mono? It's very simple. You take a load, you create a load so that you get a summing effect on that end. And the way to do this is just put a resistor in series with each side. Inside there, there may be one. They may have put a resistor in there of like 100 ohms just to compensate for long cables and so on, so it doesn't oscillate, all that jazz. But forget about that. Just consider that you're seeing it from here. Put in a resistance series with both sides. This resistance could be anything from about, you know, 470 ohms, I'm talking about the standard ones, to about 4.7K, even 10K, depending on what you're seeing on that end. Because I don't know what I'm going to see at the input there, usually it's high impedance. It's usually the volume control that I'm seeing in there. What I normally do is I'd use a 1K ohm resistor. Low power, low wattage. There's not much current going through there anyway. Put this in there, and my mono signal is now safe to use. Okay? I'm going to build one of these very, very quickly, show you how easy it is. But I've got to warn you that there's one drawback with this system, and that is that this ground that goes into the radio is the same ground that goes, basically, is coming from your iPod or your iPhone or your MP3 player, okay? You are shorting the grounds. If your radio is not an isolated one, if, for example, if this is a hot chassis radio, this ground on the radio could well be live or neutral of the mains. And that's a whole different subject that you can look up, and it's pretty well documented. The hot chassis concept is very, very well documented, and I don't need to go into that here. But what it could do, and especially in a place like Madeira, Portugal, where we don't have polarized plugs, if I don't have a polarized plug, it's a lottery. If I connect my radio to the mains and it doesn't have a transformer, this here could literally be live, which is 240 volts AC. Okay, which means that my ground on my radio, on my MP3 player or iPhone, will also be 240 volts AC, which means that I'll probably be dead very soon, because the whole body of the instrument is probably grounded. So you've got to be careful with that. You cannot use this safely with a radio that doesn't use a power transformer in there, which means that your ground is safe. Do not use it. This is done at your own risk anyway. I've got to warn you, okay? Anyway, I've made a lot of these, and let's get down to it. I'll show you how easy it is. First thing you need is you need one of these jacks. You need some audio cable, and you need a couple of these banana jacks, all right? And a couple of resistors, which we'll get to in a minute. What I do is I buy one of these cables. This particular one, if I follow it through, is about 2 meters, okay? Instead of buying raw cable and a separate plug, the easiest way to do this is I take one of these and I cut it in half and I end up with two, right? Simple. It just makes it a lot easier to work with. I don't need to solder anything here, so I get two out of one. Right, put the one aside. That's going to be for the next radio that I do. What you have here is the usual. This one's actually got a screening, so you've got your live, left, right, and ground. Now these guys are connected to the left channel, the tip on this end. It doesn't really matter which is which. One of these is the tip, the other one is the sleeve, and then that is the screen back there. Okay, so I've got access to my jack. That part's done. Now what we need to do here is we need to connect this to the banana jacks. But first of all, we need to short the two signals. So let me get myself some. Here's our two signals. Got to get myself two 1K resistors. I'll just prepare them for my ready. And that one's ready. Straighten that out. Straighten that out. And we'll just get that onto the helping hands. There's our two, left channel, right channel. We can now join these two together. give it another connector here. So here's our mono signal, ground, okay? Now we've got to get these guys to the banana plugs. Next, we get two equal pieces of audio cable. This is the simple cable with shielding and a single core in the middle, all right? This, I believe, is from an old guitar cable, so nothing too special. But I do prefer to use audio cable instead of normal wire, which you could also use. Okay, take the coating off there and do the same for all of them. What I do is I take off very little of the screening here and a longer piece on the other side. So that there is the side that's going to join up the resistor network, and those two shorter ones are going to go to the jacks themselves. So once I've done that, I separate these guys and I'm ready to go. So what am I doing here? I'm connecting one of them. This one here is connecting to the mono. This is going to the mono signal, like that, and I'm going to solder it there. Now, this is going to be my mono signal. So I don't use the shield here. Why have I got the shield at all? Well, what I'm going to do is this shield on this end, remember this is my signal, not the ground. At this end, I'm going to cut that off because that is just going to go into my jack plug. All right? My signal. Why have I got this ground at all here? Well, because my signal's coming out of the mono, going through there to the plug, if I have the screen around it, the shield, and I connect that to ground, I'm basically screening the signal that's going to the radio. Okay, so I'm just giving it a bit of screening on its way there. All right. The other one, this one, is different. This is going to be the ground. This is going to go to the ground jack. So this thing is all ground, okay? So what I can do is literally put that all together. This is all ground. And over here, same thing. Both of these are ground. I don't even need to have a shielding here. I just want to make the wires look the same. So that's ready for the blackjack. Now, I've got to connect this whole thing here. And that is now done. But it looks very crappy, right? So to get around that, we'll just use a bit of bigger heat shrink. And do this before you put the jacks on, or it won't fit. And that's done. Two banana jacks, 4 millimeter. These are the cheapest you can get on the market. Very simple. I don't need this thing for anything special. So this will do. What I need to do here, I've got to be careful that that screen that I cut does not touch the connector. So I'll just put a little bit of heat shrink on there as well, just to make sure that it insulates that part of it properly. Otherwise, you're basically shorting the signal. There we go. Now this can go in there. Let's give them a bit of solder, just to make them stay better. Just tin the ends. Alright, so we've tinned the ends. Your ground one, remember the one where it's all ground, that goes into the black. And your mono signal goes into the red. And we are done. Okay? This thing looks a bit of a mess here, so what you can do, and I'll give you an example of one I did here. I took one of those covers from a ferrite bead, the ones they used to just to clean up signals and not allow any noise to go through power supply cables and so on. Just unclip that and put all that mess inside there, and you end up with something like that, right? There are various ways of doing it. You can use all sorts of things just to create like a round tubular cover on there, put heat shrink on the top, but it actually looks very professional. So let's try this out. My two new jacks, this one goes into ground, that one goes into the input. This goes into the music source. I have my radio on. I've got my pickup input selected. This is connected to the back. I connect it to the headphone jack, in this case, my iPad. Let's get some music going. Volume here works. You can control the volume from here, and then you control the volume from here. Seems like we're making up more than we're making love. And it always seems you got something on your mind. You can actually use this volume control here perfectly, and you've got yourself a speaker. And your controls here work perfectly, your bass and your treble, your volume control there. and of course your volume control on here. Pause, play, etc. And that's it. That's basically it. You've got yourself a speaker for your MP3 player. Depending on the quality of your radio and in the speakers that it has, this can be a really, really good quality solution to play your music other than headphones. So this has made this useful and more useful. And it's actually the way that I have found to get my 17-year-old daughter to find something cool about these radios, because otherwise she just thinks I'm an old fart playing with obsolete equipment. A lot of people actually use mono to stereo converters in reverse. Now, mono to stereo is fine, but stereo to mono, you should not just use a Y cable. Hope that was useful to you, and I'll see you again soon.